UH quarterback Colt Brennan has been arrested for DUI and promotion of a dangerous drug.
It happened late last night as he was driving home to Kailua. Manolo Morales reports.
Colt Brennan walked out of the Honolulu police cell block around noon today. He was released pending further investigation. Police records show that Brennan was arrested just before midnight in Kailua. He was initially stopped for a traffic offense. His attorney says Brennan thought he had passed the field sobriety test, but he was booked for suspicion of driving under the influence. Officers then found Brennan in possession of an illegal drug, but the attorney would not specify what it is.
Well, I have an idea what it is, but I don't want to comment unless it comes back to be something that's real. If it's something that looks like something else and it's not, I'd hate to put that on. It was not pills. That's all I know.
Whatever it was, Green says it was a small amount and that Brennan had been speeding when officers initially pulled him over.
And supposedly he got stopped going 10 miles over, coming up behind the officer's car, which means the officer never clocked him.
Green says Brennan is disoriented and depressed and cites his injuries from the car crash that happened on the Big Island 2 years ago. Brennan was hurt in a head-on collision while riding in an SUV driven by his then-girlfriend.
I think he suffered, whether they call it a brain injury or not, I think he did. And I think they're trying to deal with different triggers in his life that can cause you, you know, to get severely depressed.
Brennan tried to play in the Canadian Football League but was released last month by the Saskatchewan Rough Riders. Green says Brennan was planning to stay in Hawaii and was hoping to find some work helping the community and is now devastated by this incident.
He is so obviously depressed to me, and I think the best word for it is he's sad. He is so sad, you know, I look in his eyes and I can tell he hasn't slept.
Manolo Morales, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.
Many in the state commented via social media their shock and disappointment over Brennan's arrest. Breanne Randall joins us now with more. Breanne?
That's right, Justin, especially Big Island resident Dr. Teresa Wang, the woman critically injured when her car was crashed into by the SUV Brennan was riding in 2 years ago. Brennan made no comments after spending almost 12 hours at the HPD main station following his arrest. Wang says after hearing the news this morning, she reached out to his father by email to offer support, but did not go easy on Brennan when speaking with KHON2 News.
I was really sorry for his family, his parents. They must be going through. I think he's a selfish man. All about himself and not about other people. So what can you do?
And just being such a bad role model, you know, there are so many, not only other students, but younger kids around the state who look up to these guys. It's just really terrible actions.
While in police custody, a representative for Wang's attorney tried to give Brennan a subpoena for his deposition regarding the 2010 car crash. But Brennan invoked his right to refuse visitors, and he could not be served. Brennan is released pending investigation. His attorney says the case now goes to the prosecutor's office, and it could take 1 to 3 months before he is formally charged. Breanne Randall, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.